Hello everyone. So welcome to my channel Happiness at Your Fingertips. So today's video is completely on sunflowers and how I have grown sunflower in my entire little small space that I have. So many of my friends have already questioned me because I have provided a number of pictures in my social media pages. So a number of friends have already wanted to know that how I have grown sunflowers in this little space. So yes, sunflowers are such flowers that require large places for harvest. They need large fields to get harvested. And in this entire world, there are almost 80 varieties of sunflowers. But then luckily, I have got, I have managed to get that little miniature breed of sunflower, which is one amongst all those 80 breeds. And I really love it. This is my first harvest, harvesting of sunflowers. And I really loved it. So let me tell you, these little bits are really bits of happiness to me, and they really mean a lot. I have worked for quite some time, like 2 or 3 months, on these plants to get into fully grown up, and they have really shown themselves up, and I'm totally happy from my heart. So if any of you want to grow sunflowers at home in your small space, so this is the video for you, and I hope you will like it. So please be with me to enjoy the entire video and to know the tips and the tricks how to grow sunflower in a small space, even at your home. So please be with me. Thank you.
Okay, so sunflowers are beautiful tall perennial plants. So these are miniature sunflower breeds grown in my well-lit balcony. And to give a brief background, sunflowers, originated actually in some southern parts of America long back, and there are over 70 species of sunflower all over the world. So generally, sunflowers are quite happy flowers that I feel. They bring hope and happiness to mind and home. And these miniature sunflowers are easy to grow in pots. They take the seeds take 4 to 5 days to germinate, and to my experience, till it sprouts, it should be kept in complete shade. Sunflowers are summer plants, and they actually need 6 to 8 hours of full sunlight, and the best season to harvest them is in the month of March and April. It at least needs 3 months to fully grow up into a good flowering plant and grows up to a height of about 2 to 3 feet according to the pot you are putting it in. The soil of sunflowers should be well drained, and for proper growth the water should be only poured when the topsoil remains dry. Overwatering out of too much care may spoil the roots, so please do not overwater. And as for fertilizers, I would suggest some vermicompost or some cow dung manure when the plant reaches of at least 1 foot height or a little more, in order to boost its growth and bear better flowers. Well, now, as observed by me, it really needs patience to see a first bloom, because all it's all about nature, and nature has its own reproductive cycle. So the bud takes to bloom of at least 7 to 8 days. If all the above climatic conditions that I said are satisfied fully. So this is all I could share with you, and this is my first sunflower harvest at my small balcony space. And two things is the climate, the sunny space. It should be a well-lit sunny space. And the soil condition should be proper in order to harvest sunflower properly. The breed should be proper that you take for your harvest. So this is all what I could share with you regarding my process of harvesting sunflowers, even in a small area. You can also find the variety of details in the description box below I have provided you. And well, folks, in case if you have any kind of queries or feedbacks, then please feel free to drop down your comment or feedback in the comment box below, and provide your valuable feedback or suggestions if you want me to come up with some more new exciting videos. So thank you all, and be with me. Stay happy just like this sunflower.
Okay, so I guess you have liked my video, and in that case, I would like to show you something. So here is the plant that was struck with mealybugs. As you remember, I had uploaded a video a few days back, how you can remove mealybugs from your plants in an easy homemade way. I had uploaded a video. So this is the plant that was struck with mealybug, and it has bloomed into beautiful flower now because there are no mealybugs into it. So that was because of the shampoo or the hand wash spray that I have made a few days back. And this also has a bud now. Another bud that is coming up, and I am pretty happy with it. So this is how you can, you know, grow your own plants in your own little space. And I hope you have liked my video and the small tricks that I have, you know, tried to give it to you. And in that case, if you have liked my video, then please do like and do subscribe to my channel. And do not forget to press the bell button beside subscribe. That will really help all of us. And in case of any queries or feedback that you want to give it to me, then please put it down in the comment box below. I will be happy to help you. And your feedbacks are really important to me, because that is going to improvise me and help me, you know, to create more new beautiful videos for you all. So thank you. Be with me. Thanks for watching.